thank you. Yes, this is a genuine Versace, yes. £24.99 East Street Markets. If you want one, fucking get one of your own. Do you know, I'm getting a cold, and I'm coming here tonight about, well, coming at 2 o'clock this afternoon, I felt like shit. And then one of the bands gave me a Beecham's powder, and I feel marvellous. I never knew you chopped them up on a minute and slipped through a £5 note. I just put my bag down. There's nobody in from Birkenhead, is there? You know what they're like? They have magnets and fishing rods, and you see your handbag slide off the stage like a dollop of snot on a lavatory tile. Next thing you know, your family allowance is pissed up the wall. I had the standard Catholic sex education. Nothing. Fuck all. But it's not exactly true. My mother sat me down and she said, do you know the man's? I said, She said, and you know the woman's? I said, what, oh, weekly? What? She said, no. Why did it? My mother, when she wants to talk about something she doesn't understand, she mutters, so you say to her, how's your mate? She'll go, oh, she's not well. So what's up with her? She'll go, ah. Or she'll say, do you know those two women up the road who live together? I say, yeah. She'll go, They're the what? I was 24 before I discovered a gay woman wasn't called that. You know, And my mother went on a coach trip and say, what was York like? She'd say, oh, the toilets were beautiful. Or if she went in a restaurant and say, what was it like? She'd say, ooh, should have seen the toilets. All those years as my mother was a cottage queen and I never knew. Fucking hell, it just shows you. Just shows you. Anyway, I must read this out to you. We all got one of these through the post. It's a questionnaire. What is your favourite sexual position? I couldn't fucking believe this. This and the Reader's Digest came on Monday morning. Can you remember the first time you had sex? I can't fucking remember the last, to tell you the truth. Do you spit or do you swallow? What kind of question is that to ask anyone? What sort of filth is that to say, do you spit? I think oral sex is the most disgusting thing in the world. Men's dicks, my. Them little fat ones full of veins like a pensioner's leg. You think I'm putting one of them in my gob? You got another fucking thing coming. Well, not for less than 50 quid anyway, I'll tell you. It's true. I don't know what God was thinking about when he made the reproductive organ, because the woman's isn't much better, is it? It looks like a tomcat with a throat cut. Have you seen it? Ooh, and then balls hanging like two used tea bags swinging off your chin. Oh. It's so fucking uncomfortable lying there with two big hairy thighs out the side of your face. You can't even get your gob open, you're like a goldfish. You're blowing air in instead of sucking. And as for pump in the mouth, you know what I mean? It was like a vitamin E capsule exploding. Oh. I've never done it once. That was by mistake. You sat in the bed going. You're turning green, the sweat's running off you like a glass blower's arse. He's taking ages getting dressed, smiling at you. So you'd like a cup of coffee, you go, Please fuck off, so I can spit this out. And then they get through, so you want to kiss you again, go, Pull the headboard down, get out and walk. Well, that's filthy, I suppose. I'll tell you what it is fucking filthy. When it's windy and you're walking behind a fella in the street, and it's always fellas who do this, and they go... and it all flies back and it's hanging off the hood of your anorak. Or they go... and it's the wheelie of a shopping trolley going down Sainsbury's like a bloody snail leaving tracks. And why do fellas wipe the dicks on the duvet when they've had a shag? That really pisses me off, I tell you. Little crusty bit, I blame the cats. So my cats are on, well, one of them was on each, she's just come off, the other one's come on now, fucking screaming 5 o'clock in the morning. But yeah, we don't like a shag, but we're not dragging our asses on the cork floor and get to sleep. I'm sat on the couch trying to eat me dinner and they come in backside first. This hole like a white knuckle rider at Alton Towers. Your sausage is sucked off the place. All the peas go individually. Your spuds fly off, you're hanging off the arm of the couch, your flip-flops are beating fuck out the soles of your feet, the curtains are stiff. Jesus Christ, and when they get on your knee and this... all your fillings are being moved. But the neighbours thought it was me, you know, when I was embarrassed. So I'd had enough this night, because I was angst, because I'm not in the Valley anymore. They took my office, and the Halcyon, fucking bastards. I want Prozac, but he won't give it me. And, so I got up and I put a rubber glove on. And I don't recommend this for anybody at home. A marigold, full-length evening glove. And went in the kitchen, and they're there writhing by the bin. And I went, shut up. How do you explain in Casualty, 5 o'clock in the morning, a Persian cat hanging off the end of your hands? Hey. Should have seen me getting on the bus. I just pretend it was my handbag. Go, oh, yes. I hope you've enjoyed your night. Thank you very much for coming. See you later. Ta-ra.